Woohoo!
Traction control. It's a really simple system that can absolutely save your bacon out on a ride. All right, real talk about big, heavy adventure bikes. These things have way too much horsepower and way too much weight to get crazy off-road. And when you're riding them on the street, a lot of the times you've got knobby tires that are really well suited for off-road riding, but are limiting the amount of traction you have on the pavement. Traction control is great for adventure bikes because if you're riding off-road, you really are gonna have a hard time putting down 100 or more horsepower to dirt, and the traction control can keep you from getting into a whiskey throttle situation or just getting in over your head and having a big old crash. And on the pavement, some of the choices you've made setup-wise on the motorcycle that limit its safety riding on the street can be mitigated by having a system that kind of pays attention to you so that you don't spit yourself off into a high side mid-corner or get caught out riding over some slippery paint. The way the system works is it uses a wheel speed sensor on the front wheel and a wheel speed sensor on the rear wheel, and it compares those two speeds to keep your motorcycle in line. The early systems were available right about 2008. When it noticed the rear wheel was spinning too fast for what the front wheel was doing, it simply pulled spark away from the engine on the motorcycle and slowed down the rear wheel. If your bike has that kind of system, you'll know when it kicks in because it sounds like the motorcycle's breaking down. The spark is cutting out, so the engine will start missing, almost like you're hitting a rev limiter.
The second generation of traction control is the fly-by-wire style that we saw introduced in around 2012 from Ducati. On a fly-by-wire throttle system, your throttle tube here is no longer directly physically connected to the throttle bodies on your engine. There's a sensor up top that's measuring how far open the throttle is, and then that is going to go through the computer and down to your throttle bodies, and they will open as much, or if the traction control is intervening, it will dial it back a little.
If your motorcycle is equipped with traction control, you absolutely need to learn how to use it. That way you can get the most out of every single ride and make sure that your bike's not holding you back in some situations where you might not even know it. Ride modes on adventure bikes take advantage of the fly-by-wire throttle and the traction control system to completely change the way that the bike puts power to the ground, and it'll totally change your ride. These bikes have everything from a sport mode, which takes the throttle turn and makes it super quick, really abrupt, and it turns the sensitivity of the traction control down so you can actually get a little bit of a slide before it starts to dial power back. And they also have a rain mode where it takes the throttle turn and makes it really slow, where the bike will dial power on really slowly and carefully, and it has super aggressive traction control in that mode to make sure that the bike does not get out of shape at all, no matter how slippery the surface is. A lot of adventure bikes have optional off-road ride modes, and what that mode does is it takes the throttle turn and actually puts it in a similar mode to that rain mode, but rather than letting you get all the way to full throttle, it dials the power back on the top end of the rev range so that this bike goes from making 125 horsepower to making about 100 horsepower. On top of that, the traction control in the off-road mode allows the rear wheel to spin two full revolutions for one revolution on the front wheel, and that lets you get a good slide going and also lets you loft the front wheel over small obstacles off-road. If you look at the tracks on the sand, the first one here is from rain mode, and you can see that two wheels tracked perfectly in line with each other, even though mid-corner, I whacked the throttle right to full wide open. The second set of tracks here is from off-road mode, and you can see that mid-corner, whacked the throttle wide open, and the bike brings the back end out a ways, and then holds it there in a nice gradual loop the whole way around the corner. A lot of the adventure bikes with this second generation traction control system are actually equipped with pitch and yaw sensors. So at all times, the motorcycle knows the attitude of the chassis. If you're leaned into a corner, it won't give you full throttle even if you ask for it. It'll slowly dial the power in as you stand the bike up. Steep rocky hill climbs are another place where traction control can make or break your entire ride. Coming up this hill, I had the throttle absolutely pinned the entire way. The traction control system on this bike was set to rain mode, and you can see that the bike absolutely controls the wheel spin. There's hardly any input from me whatsoever. I'm literally just holding that throttle wide open, and the bike climbed right to the top of the hill with no problems. I personally like a little bit more drama than that in my motorcycle rides, but it's great to get to the top of the hill without even breaking a sweat. The current generation traction control system is pretty invisible most of the time while you're riding, But the number one situation where you absolutely will feel it and it will cause you problems is riding in deep, soft sand. I'm talking about sand dune kind of sand where it's really dry and really deep. In that situation, you need rear wheel speed to get the bike moving and get up on top of that loose sand. And the traction control system is going to be constantly slowing that back wheel down, and you aren't going to be able to get enough momentum up to even get up the smallest hill. An experienced rider can manage traction really well by moving their weight forward and backward on a motorcycle, managing where the throttle position is, and applying power by using the clutch at the appropriate times. If you give the motorcycle exactly what it wants, your traction control system will never engage. But for a newer rider, somebody who hasn't really fine-tuned their ability to manage traction on the ground, an electronic traction control system is a fantastic way to keep your ride safe and secure.